Hey everybody, it's Captain Charlie here, and I'm at my dock right now. We just got back from filming, and we had a few people that asked some questions, so I'm going to try to cover them. One of y'all out there, Cody Ford, you had asked me about jig heads, and just wondering, like, when should you use certain ones, how to rig them up, you know, for weights, not really rigging, but like, what weights should you use during certain situations? Well, I'll tell you real quick, you always want to make sure when it comes to fishing, you know, if you're jigging on the bottom, let's say, we're going to start with that. You have to increase the size of the jig head weight compared to the strength of the current or the tide. And what I mean by that is if you have a really hard tide, you got to use a really big jig head, something like a 3/8 ounce jig head. You could even go bigger than this to 1/2 ounce, 5/8. You go to a really big jig head to properly have that bait when it goes to the bottom and you give it a little jig. As it jumps up, it just travels and it goes kind of slow across the bottom like this. You don't want, if you throw an 1/8 ounce jig head and really, you know, a really small jig head, like an 1/8 ounce jig head like this, I can tell you right now, this isn't even going to reach the bottom because the displacement of the current on your fishing line, then on the jig head and the bait that you have on, this will never make it to the bottom where the fish are holding. And this is mostly and mainly during the winter seasons or like in the fall when the fish start dropping kind of deep. You want to make sure that you use something that's a little bit heavier. You want to get down. But in certain situations, even during the winter time, when you're fishing, let's say in 10 feet or 15 feet of water, if the tide isn't moving very much, you're going to want to make sure that your bait has a slow fall to it due to the reason that the fish strike zones get smaller with less current and less tide. So during that, you would pick up an 1/8 ounce jig head and you would use that jig head compared to something that's bigger like this jig head, which is a 3/8 ounce jig head. And the reason for that is that the 3/8 ounce jig head would go right to the bottom. And every time you jig it, it would just go straight back down, straight back down. It wouldn't have a fall to it and a slow presentation for those fish to see it and instinctively strike on it. So your jig size or your weight is comparable to the amount of current that you have. So less current, less weight jig head. More current, more weight jig head. And like I said, I always kind of keep, you know, different types of jig heads in my tackle box that I have on my boat. But mainly what I have is I have 1/8 ounce, I carry 1/4 ounce, I carry 3/8 ounce, 5/8, and 1/2 ounce. 1/2 ounce I use probably the least because I don't really fish in that deep of water and I don't fish that hard of current. Believe it or not, majority of the time if I'm using a 1/2 ounce jig head, that is when I am fishing, let's say, out by the rigs. The current's moving pretty hard, and I can't get it to the bottom. I'll throw a 1/2 ounce jig head on there just to get it down. You know, or if I'm fishing bull reds and I'm using big croakers to use for those, I got to have something heavy to bring that croaker to the bottom, so I'd use that 1/2 ounce jig head. That's the only time. But probably my 1/4 and 3/8 ounce are the two that I use the most, okay? Now, Cody asked also, hey, what about using for double rigs? What size should I use? I'll tell you, I only use two different jig heads when I'm fishing double rigs. What I use is either 2/4 ounce, and I'll have them, you know, separated out for a double rig, or I'll put a 3/8 ounce at the back and 1/4 in the front. Okay, and that just gives me a little bit more ability to cast further. And I think a lot of times that 3/8 ounce just gets down a little bit deeper than 1/4, and they kind of run a little bit more in line when I'm in heavier current. And that's the only time that I'd probably do that. I rig it like that pretty often just due to the reason that it works better when you're retrieving. 2/4 work great when you have no current. But if you have current, you gotta upgrade, you gotta increase, just like I said before, you gotta increase that weight a little bit. You could even do 2/3 ounce on there if the current's really ripping hard and you got a real big paddle tail, let's say, that you're using for your baits. But yeah, double rigs, 2/4, 1/4, and 3/8, or if heavy current, 2/3. Okay, so that's that. Now, lastly, a lot of people ask me a lot of times, hey, you know, when you're fishing, I see that you fish a jig head a lot, but when would you use, let's say, a Carolina rig compared to a jig head? Why would you use one or the other? Now, I'll tell you, jig heads, I use them almost exclusively, And the reason why is because it's easier to rig. I really don't find the advantage of a Carolina rig compared to a jig head. For me personally, I find that the jig head, when I'm trying to fish on the bottom, I really like to have that bait on the bottom. When you use a Carolina rig and you have that bait down, that bait will swim and everything. But if you have any kind of current, like, you know, decent current, that bait gets pushed down to the bottom, you know, and it's not swimming around. It's not doing anything. That thing's going straight to the bottom. And a jig head eliminates that slide between the Carolina rig. Lots of people are very productive on Carolina rigs. I'm not saying that they don't work or that they're not good. It's just the thing is that for me and the customers and what I use for bait, I am telling you a jig head just works better for me, okay? Now, if you want to say what ones would you use, around the rigs, a lot of people like to use Carolina rigs because it brings it right down to the bottom where those fish are holding at the bases of the pilings or the pipes that are there. But the only problem with a Carolina rig is you get caught up a lot. You break off a whole bunch. That, on the other hand, what a jig head is if you get stuck with a jig head, you can ping that jig head off, and when it comes loose, you can pull it right in and then rebait and then throw back out. Carolina rig works well, but usually when you're throwing away from the rig, not towards the rig. I'll use a jig head, and I'll throw right inside of the rig because I know if I get stuck, as long as somebody doesn't set the hook or I don't set the hook and I feel it and it just gets stuck, you can ping that thing right off of there, and you can get that jig head back every time without having to re-rig. Now, Carolina rigging sometimes over oyster beds works really, really well, you know, because that bait is down, you're not around a lot of current, and that bait can move around properly, and it works really well. But I just prefer a jig head, but most people that I know that fish a lot in deeper water like to use a Carolina rig, and I really think it's just because they like it to get to the bottom and they can feel it better. I like a jig head because I think it falls and presents itself a lot better. So try them both, see which one works, but I will just tell you, only time I'd put a Carolina rig on is when I'm fishing bull reds or sharks and I'm using steel leader and I need to get it down to the bottom because I'm fishing outside of the rigs where there's heavy, heavy current and I can't use just a jig head. It just doesn't work. I have to get something really heavy. I'm using 3 ounces or 2 ounces worth of weight to get that thing to the bottom and I need that steel leader because, you know, those big bulls and those sharks, they pop the line all the time with their teeth. So, well, Cody, I hope that helped, and I hope it helped all of y'all out there. Make sure you give me a suggestion on the bottom. Press subscribe at the bottom also. That makes the YouTube gods all happy and helps us out a whole bunch. And if you have any other questions or anything like that, just comment below. We'll be glad to help you out, okay? I'll see y'all maybe out on the water.